A lot of people have asked me to make a Blender to Godot tutorial, specifically how to take a Blender animation and turn it into something game ready, like what you're seeing right now. I really liked the idea, but instead of making a tutorial only about exporting animations, I thought it would be more interesting showing you the entire pipeline, from handling the assets in Inkscape to exporting them in Blender to importing everything properly into Godot. This way you get a full, holistic view of the workflow, and hopefully some inspiration to start creating your own art and animations. And that's exactly what this video is going to cover. But before we jump in, if you want to learn more about drawing and game art in Inkscape, make sure to subscribe, leave a like, and leave a comment. It genuinely helps the channel a lot. And if you want to take your Inkscape skills to the next level, stay until the end, I got something for you. Here I am in Inkscape. I've already prepared all the drawings. Everything is grouped neatly, and I've separated static assets from animated ones. For static assets, exporting is super simple. Select everything, go to File, Export, Batch Export. Leave the settings as they are, we want PNGs, and click Export. I could have named everything in the Layers panel so the exports get proper file names, but honestly, we are going to rename them in Godot anyway, so it's fine. And that's it, static assets are ready to go. For the animatable assets, I covered in detail the export process in my previous video. I don't want to waste your time repeating everything here, so let's jump straight into Blender. Here I am in Blender, and I have one of the four animated elements, in this case, the main character. In the dope sheet, you can see I've created two actions, idle and run, because this project was created using the 2D animation workspace. Go to File, New, 2D animation. Blender has already set up several things for us. We got a camera pointing at the grease pencil object, which is in the correct orientation. We got proper world colors and lights. And very importantly, we have correct color management settings. You can configure all of this manually, but starting with the workspace saves a lot of time. These are the minimum settings needed to export grease pencil animations accurately, but we still need to adjust a few things to make the export work properly. First, we need a transparent background. Go to Render Properties, the little camera icon. Under Film, enable Transparent. This removes the white background and sets it to transparent at the moment of exporting. Now we need to set the resolution and size. Under the Output Properties tab, pick the resolution. This determines how large the exported PNG frames will be. My recommendation is setting the resolution to something like your monitor max resolution. Then you control the exporting resolution by lowering it using the percentage slider. This makes it easier to estimate how big the character will appear in-game. For example, if you want the character to take about 25% of the screen, you get the right resolution based on that percentage. If your character is centered in the middle of the screen, like mine, you'll want the character to be as big as possible. The easiest and safest way to do this is to adjust the camera position. Press numpad 0 to enter camera view. Now select the camera in the outliner and go to the object data properties, and adjust the Y and Z values until the character fits nicely within the screen. Chances are you still have empty space on the sides. To avoid all that waste of space, go to View, Render, Render Region, and drag to crop all the unnecessary empty space. Just make sure to scroll the animation back and forth to make sure you're cropping the right amount. Then go back to the Output Properties, and in Format enable Crop to Render Region so Blender only exports that area. And finally, some output settings. In the output panel, here you choose where you want to save the images. Set the file format to PNG. And set the color to RGBA. This will make it so it exports with proper transparency. Everything else can stay as it is. Now just go to Render, Render Animation, and Blender will export one PNG per frame, numbered in order. I recommend exporting each animation into its own folder to keep things clean when importing into Godot. I'm not going to walk you through building a full game. There are already great tutorials for that. Instead, I'll show you specifically how to set up your animations, collisions, and scenes so everything works properly in Godot. When you create your Godot project, it generates a folder on your computer. Move all your PNGs, including static assets and animated sequences, into a folder like assets. We have three kinds of assets to set up: static assets with collisions, things like trees or buildings. Then we have pure static assets with no collision, things like these colorations that do not interact with the characters. And then we have the animated characters, and everything that's animated. Let's start with the static assets with collision. Create a new scene. Set the root node to static body 2D. Add a 2D sprite as a child. And drag the PNG you want to the sprite 2D texture slot. Now add a collision shape 2D. And choose a shape and adjust it in the editor. And that's it. For pure static assets, that's even simpler, drag the PNG into the scene panel. Godot will create a sprite 2D node automatically. There is no need to create a scene, unless you're thinking in doing something more complex later on. The animated characters are the most complex because they need collision, an animation player, and optionally scripts, hotboxes, and physics. Here's the basic setup. Create a new scene, set character body 2D as the root node, add an animated sprite 2D. And in the inspector, go to sprite frames, create new sprite frame resource. Delete the default animation. Now create a new animation and rename it idle. Click add frames from file. And select all the PNGs for the idle animation. Godot will order them automatically. Set the FPS to match Blender's, 24 FPS if you remember. You can preview with play. Run repeat for run or any other animation. Believe it or not, that's all you need for moving your drawings and animations into Godot. It's super easy. Now to actually move the character, use that script, but honestly there are entire channels focused on Godot scripting that will teach you that part much better than I can. Hopefully by now you have a clear idea of how to export your drawings in Inkscape, export them out of Blender, and bring them into an actual game through Godot. If you want to learn how to actually draw your game art, I have a bundle of 13 full Inkscape courses covering character design, background art, game art, and much more. Over 70 hours of beginner-friendly content that will take you from absolute zero to full Inkscape mastery. Link in the description. This tutorial was requested by a lot of you, so let me know in the comments what topic you want me to tackle next. That's it for today, thanks for watching, and I'll see you next week. Bye!